As usual, normally we say good afternoon, good evening, but with Janardhan Reddy garu's presence here, we have to say we are all Swachh Namaskar, or Swachh Good Evening, whichever it is. Very good. And I am not very sure why I am invited as a chief guest for this function. Organizers, whatever they thought, I am basically a scientist working in the Department of Ministry of Defense. Whereas people like Janardhan Reddy garu, they are all day in, day out, working in the problems faced in the city of Hyderabad, trying to improve the city of Hyderabad. As it says, daily getting more than 3,500 mails and responding to that and all those things. These are all something too special. Whereas we are in a different way trying to contribute to the development of city of Hyderabad, which I'll narrate it a little later. But whenever we say a city has to find its place, has to make a mark in the history of the world, the city should have basically any place to get a mark in history of better living conditions always need to be better with infrastructure, safety, security, connectivity, mobility, and of course better climatic conditions and with high cultural values. This is what generally need to have for a city to have a mark of itself. But for Hyderabad, when we look at it, when there were floods in the year 1908, Musi, the great floods, what they were there, Sir Mokshagundam Vishwesharaya was contacted, and he has studied Hyderabad and related issues and many other problems which are connected to Hyderabad. And in the year 1909, he submitted a report to Hyderabad, how to develop Hyderabad. In fact, he has suggested in the report what he has submitted in the year October 1909 to construct two reservoirs in Hyderabad, have a complete underground drainage, establish city development authority, then to construct a river bank and beautify the river bank, all through the river bank. These are all some of those ideas or salient features what he has given there. He again came and visited and has gone through the total what has been done in the year 1929 and 1930. He says that there is much yet to be done a lot here in this city. He stated that to improve the city, when the improvement suggested were carried out and the city was equipped with clean houses, flush down lavatories, dustless roads, paved footpaths, and a plenty of supply of open spaces, parks, gardens, and it was thought Hyderabad would be able to hold her head high among her sister cities in India. This is what a remark what he has made when he came in the year 1929-1930. And when we look at it now, a lot more a difference, a lot of urbanization. Today the population has gone beyond probably 1 crore or whatever it is, what we see here. And the facilities we are out of this lot of urbanization, we are enjoying. At the same time, the problems out of this urbanization also we are getting. In fact, when we look at history, many of the cities have come or built on the banks of rivers, primarily to see that there is no water scarcity, water is plenty available, and surrounding areas there can be a lot of agriculture. It is most important for any city to develop also around surrounding areas, you need to have agriculture. Look at most of the cities what are there in the worldwide, whether you talk about Moscow, you talk about Paris or many other cities, or here also in India, many cities which have come up are on the banks of various rivers, wherein you have water supply fully. Even Hyderabad also is like that. on the banks of Musi River, Hyderabad has come up, and 400 years we have a heritage of a culture. Hyderabad, in fact, when I came here to the city in the year 1980 first, I was very, very happy about the city, the culture, the way people help each other, the type of culture you have here in the city of Hyderabad. Even now, very regularly, not because I have to speak from this dais and tell the people here, I keep telling that the culture what has been there in Hyderabad, the particularly the Basti culture, is excellent culture what we have. The people are united, they all talk to each other, they spend time to each other, they play together. There are batches of that Basti who work together, and they think a problem which comes to a boy, neighborhood boy, they think that it is the Basti problem, and it has been working like that. I've been mixing up myself with many Bastis in Hyderabad, and I've been seeing also. What I'm saying is, culture is very important for any city to have some of these features what we have said, particularly when we say that safety, security, and other aspects, and particularly for the tourism to improve a lot in any particular given city, this is very important. The culture comes out of the nativity of the particular township or particular city. If the city loses its nativity, then the culture goes off. The culture doesn't remain with the people there, and something else creeps in, and the bad things start coming into the city. There are many cities, I don't want to name anyone in India also, where those cities lost their nativity. The native culture, when you lose, the other things have crept in and many bad things started happening in that place. Now, Hyderabad, I wish that with lot of influx of many people from outside, various other places, and coming to this city, it should not lose its nativity. What I'm saying is, all the speakers who spoke here, some of you who have spoken also, when we say that the city has to be with all these features what we have said, it is not that what you create infrastructure through technology, you create communications, you create roads and things like that. It is individual who matters a lot. Individual culture, even Janardhan Reddy garu, when he was talking about it also, the culture within an individual to follow many things, to follow discipline, to maintain honesty, these are all very important. Then only the city can have a good environment, eco-friendly, whatever it is also. There are many things which have been done, like Ram Prasad was telling about what IT has contributed. Many other departments have contributed a lot to the development of this city. The number of central government institutes which are present in the city of Hyderabad, and particularly the Ministry of Defense, we have more than about 40 establishments here in the city today. Look at the R&D establishments of Ministry of Defense which are here, contributed a lot for the eco-friendly and otherwise economic growth of this city. I'll give an example of one laboratory called RCI, Research Center Imarat, for which sometime back I was director. Before the RCI being established in about 2,000 acres of land, there was no single tree or a plant there. It's a barren land what was existing. Today, there are 2,07,000 trees available in the 2,300 acres of land, thick forest what is available there. There are more than about 700 deers there. There are more than about 150 peacocks, wild boars, pythons, and other things, whatever eco-friendly related things, many things which have come up. Today, there are more than about 1,000 industries which are there in Hyderabad city, which are working for Ministry of Defense and trying to produce a lot more things and contribute to the economic growth of this country and this city. There are many things. If you talk about one particular missile called Akash, it has an order of about 24,000 crores in the last 3 years in the city. through Bharat Dynamics Limited. And 85% of those items of Akash are coming from the industries here, and BDL is integrating them and giving. Not only we are contributing to the national security, leave us aside that, this particular activity here has brought in a lot of growth in the city, and these many industries have come. But when I joined here in DRDO in the year 1985-86, we didn't have more than about 10 industries. Today, more than 1,000 industries working for it. And the way number of items are going to come up in this Make in India program and indigenization and all that, many more industries are going to come, many more startups are going to come, and a lot more things are going to happen in this city out of this. So there are many institutions like this which have contributed for the eco-friendly atmosphere here, the industry's development. And the industries particularly, we have been encouraging them to have green technologies to see that the pollution-free industry environment exists. Somewhere when we say that industry has to come up, that's naturally for the economic growth of it. We have to see that the industries are more and more using green technologies, the pollution should be less. If you look at the pollution situation of the country today, now, we were in the fifth position in the pollution, carbon dioxide producing country. Now we have gone up to the third. From 2005 to 2016, we are now grown. That means we started producing more and more carbon dioxide from the year 2005 to 2015. So the pollution also started increasing. It's not that industry has come up, many more industries are coming, and so you are economically you are growing, but we have to see that pollution side also what is happening. So we need to get more and more green technologies also. This is one of the important points. So likewise, there are many imperatives what have come out of these establishing many institutions here and for the growth of the city. Let me tell you, in fact, Janathan Edgar was talking about number of lakes and things like that. We have constructed a road from Karmangat towards to the airport, a beautiful road, one of the most beautiful roads in Hyderabad, and developed two lakes on the either side of it, and developed a complete green belt there, and a lot of plantation we have done. It is one of the beautiful roads which has been developed in Hyderabad with many junction points and whatnot and all that, what we have contributed there and coming up. So if locally, every unit, every industry, or with the help of many funding agencies and many facilities which are available with the government departments and even the GHMC, if we are able to do locally all this type of development what we are talking about today, I think the city will be much more cleaner and much more greener, and we'll have the environment what we are thinking of today for this, in this seminar today. I have made some presentation and given what infrastructure development means and infrastructure, how we have to develop, and what are the innovative infrastructure developments means also in that. Some of those points I'll touch upon. What do you mean by, when we say that, unleashing the spare capacity? How do we do that? Let's say if we take an area, and if we are able to map that area completely, and we find that there are about 20% of the houses are vacant, or 20% of the land is vacant, can we create most of the facilities what are required in those areas, in those places, so that the mobility of the people need not be going too much from one place to other place in the city? This is one of the innovative mechanisms what has been taught, what people have come out. Second, cutting out the peaks. How do we cut out the peaks? Let's say cutting out the peaks even from electricity, water consumption, road traffic, public transport, and many of these things can we bring down with modern technologies using them to 20%. This is one of the innovative ideas what people can come out, where we can cut down the peaks by 20%. We can use technology-enabled demand management or innovative pricing structures can significantly reduce these peaks. This is the second important point of what we need to think about it. Small scale infrastructure thinking. cities always will need to be having always large infrastructures, large scale infrastructures, or large fund required infrastructures which will be there. But sometimes small infrastructure from like whatever in the road traffic what we need to follow, cycle lanes, bicycle lanes, or high speed tracks, low speed tracks, and people having discipline in driving and following the rules what we need to follow, how we can use it. We have such a fantastic outer ring road what we have. I don't think, I haven't found anywhere else in the country also such a fantastic road anywhere else in India. But the number of accidents what we have on that also phenomenal, purely because we are not following the rules, or we are not having discipline and trying to, and we are not trying to understand what it is. These sort of things, why don't we follow and try to have a development of the city with this type of a roads and infrastructure what we have, with the self-discipline, and also every individual trying to have a plant in his house or surrounding areas, why not we plant something? And as you were saying about waste management, after water harvesting, and many of those things, which is a small-scale infrastructure development, which is called kind as a small-scale infrastructure development, what we need to have, which we were having. You go to the villages, which India was a village-centric country. Once upon a time, it was a village-centric country. There is no house which was not having all these features, what I'm telling. A self-contained house, a good tree, and good many antibiotic-related environment, and many other things which were there in the house, and what they were doing also with the cultivation, with the farmer-based applications, what they were having. Also, one more thing is people-centric innovation. This is one more important point what needs to be. The best way to improve a city is by mobilizing its citizens. Smart traffic lights to garbage taxes, innovations in technologies, services, governance, and many other things. This is a very important thing in governance. I think, again, Janardhan Reddy garu was mentioning about Singapore, how things happen, how a complaint can be taken, how a complaint is given, how responsibly a complaint is given, how responsibly a complaint has been followed up, and things like that and all that. This sort of a, how efficiently a system is followed when you give a complaint or when you have a system, what is followed. These are all the important things what an infrastructure, which when people say need to be followed and things like that have been used. So in end, what I try to say is that it is people-centric innovations. It is people who have to follow, people who have to be innovative about their centric, or people who have to make themselves more and more contributing to the development of the city in small to big way, whichever is required. And that culture bringing in the city and maintaining the culture of the city is the most important thing. And I appreciate the efforts of the organizers in conducting this workshop, seminar, and competitions. And I congratulate all the people who have participated here. And I congratulate all the winners of the prizes who got that many awards. In fact, I was also working on a very recently an idea with NIRD, soil-less plantation. There is no soil is required. You can have water tubs. In that plantations, vegetables can be grown. You can have fish, and both will be cycling, and both will be helping each other. One professor who has come from Ohio University, he was giving this idea. I went to NIRD, and why not we have people in the apartments can grow vegetables without a soil requirement also. So many innovations can come like this, and which can be used in the city, and which we can use it. And I am sure that the youngsters who are present here will be able to come out with many more ideas, and many more such seminars, and many more such responsible people will be able to come. Thank you very much, and all the best. Congratulations to you.